hiking with Dave and Barbara, but today we're not hiking, we're going to do another pub crawl. This is pub crawl number 6, and I think probably it's full of some of the classic, most classic pubs, traditional classic pubs in Manchester. It's a fantastic crawl. We've come off the station here, Oxford Road, which is about 30 metres that way, and we're going to do the first pub, which is the Salisbury. It is truly fantastic first pub to start. Thingston beer is great. It has a good selection here as well of other beers. Brown tiled outside, just really nice inside. Anything to add on the Salisbury, Barbara, before we head off?
No, just a really nice sort of pub dating back sort of pre-1840. Yeah. This area of Manchester was once known as Little Island, and it was one of the poorest places that you could live in Manchester at that time. Nice pub. Definitely in our top 10. Check it out.
Yeah, it's not so poor anymore. Plenty of students down there. Anyway, let's move on to pub number 2. Bye-bye. Bye. We made it to number 2, which is called the City Road. This is an amazing pub. If you look at it, it's just in the middle of building works. It's actually attached to the railway line. It's fantastic. Looks bigger on the outside than it is on the inside, and it gets very busy on Man United match day, so be wary then. But it's a great little pub. Anything to add on this one, Barbara?
It's just got a nice atmosphere inside. It's got a good selection of beers on.
Yeah.
It's actually smaller inside than it looks from the outside. So it's just got a main bar room and then a smaller room with a pool table in. But no, it's a nice little Manchester boozer.
It is, and it's got you near Bridgewater Hall, you know, GMEX there.
Deansgate Locks
there, so it's in the heart of this area of Manchester. Anyway, should we move on to pub number 3?
Yep.
Let's go, bye-bye.
Bye.
Around the corner from the City Road to pub number 3, the Britain's Protection. I suppose this is like a Manchester institution. Dating back to 1811, the name derives from the fact that it used to be a recruiting office for soldiers for the war against France, war against Napoleon. Of course, this pub was here before the Battle of Waterloo in 1815, and the Peterloo Massacre was 1819 as well. Barbara will tell you more about the inside and the clientele.
Okay, so inside it's got a main room at the front of the bar room. It sells over 300 different whiskies, lots of real ales, so check those out. There's a frieze inside all about the massacre, the 1819 Peterloo Massacre, which was on St. Peter's Fields just across the road. And it's got a nice beer garden at the back. In winter, check out the room with the fire. It's in a good location for the Bridgewater Hall, so you'll find a mixture of people in here with the whiskey drinkers, ale drinkers, people coming for a drink before going to the theatre, and members of the Halley Orchestra bobbing by too. So yeah, one of our top 10 pubs in Manchester.
It certainly is a fantastic, do not miss this place. Anyway, we're going to move on to pub number 4. The short distance down to the Rain Bar behind us. Big old building dating back to 1850, we believe. The brewery is John Willie Lee, so it's quite inexpensive, and there's plenty of real ales on. The best thing about this place is it's got a fantastic garden at the back, plenty of sitting down space. If you see your pub crawls on a sunny day, this is a great place.
You may never leave. Just stay here.
Anything to add, Barbara, on this building, or this name of the building maybe?
No, it's a lovely pub inside. I really like it, so check it out. It used to be part of a series of warehouses where there was an iron foundry and an umbrella factory. Hence, we think it took its name, the Rain Bar, from the umbrella factory that it used to be. So, come down here.
Yeah.
Nice bar, especially on a sunny day like today.
Yeah, it's big as well. You're not going to get too crowded in there.
Yep.
All right, let's move on to number 5. on to pub number 5, which is the Peveril of the Peak, and you can quite see it is simply stunning emerald green facade. The building dates back to Georgian times, or late Georgian times, and we believe the tiles were put there in Victorian times. It is quite an amazing pub. Do you want to describe anything about it, Barbara?
It's actually a Grade 2 listed building with a historic interior. Inside it's a Victorian, a lot more tiling, Victorian fireplace and the old bell pushers from when people just used to sit in their chair and drink in front of a beer. Saved from demolition in the 1980s. Can't believe that was even considered. But definitely one of our top 10 pubs. The finally, it's got football table dating back from 1955, the oldest football table in the UK.
Still in operation. Yeah, the other thing about this one, supposedly it was Eric Cantona's favourite Manchester pub when he lived here. Not sure if it's true, but who knows.
Wouldn't be surprising. It is absolutely stunning. Definitely one of our top 10 pubs in Manchester.
It certainly is. And we're going to move on to pub number 6. Bye.
Bye.
Just walk the short distance to pub number 6, the Sir Ralph Abercrombie. Sir Ralph Abercrombie, of course, was a politician, a soldier, and he was also governor of Trinidad at one point. Not quite sure of what his connection to Manchester was, but the pub is named after him. The pub dates back to 1780, and the Peterloo Massacre, the tragic events of the Peterloo Massacre, happened just up the street there, and the injured were brought to this pub, apparently. Anything else to add on this, Barbara?
It's a very old pub. Unfortunately, the inside, the old historic centre of it has been like taken out, I don't know when. It's got a lovely beer garden on the side though, and it's got like a big frieze inside commemorating the Peterloo Massacre. In 2014, it was threatened with demolition together with the police station next door and the synagogue by a consortium of developers led by United favourite Gary Neville. It took 3 years of opposition and camera getting involved, so it's now been saved. So that development isn't now going ahead, so come and save her. Manchester's one of Manchester's oldest pub. We've not found an older one, have we?
No, we haven't.
No, so dating back 1780, absolutely fantastic.
All right, we're going to move on to pub number 7. Okay, let's go.
Bye.
On to pub number 7, which is the Old Nag's Head. Look at the frontage, it is truly fantastic. You see the sign up there which says rebuilt 1880. It is the inside, unlike the Abercrombie, which is, there's nothing original left. This has got its full Victorian decor inside, still in one piece. Loads of memorabilia about Man United, it's a proper Man United pub. Also, it claims to be the sign there says the George Best pub. Not really sure, but it is a fantastic place. Anything to add on the Old Nag's Head, Barbara?
First floor, big selection of pool tables. Second floor, rooftop terrace, sometimes open. I've not found it open myself, but never mind. And like Dave says, check out all the pictures of all old Manchester people. At one time in the 1960s, bands who were playing locally, Eric Clapton, Rolling Stones, Rod Stewart, Bob Byford beer as well. Mm. So it's a lovely, old, authentic, they sell curry half and half.
Great place though. So this is pub number 7 and we'll move on to pub number 8. Bye bye.
Bye.
Okay, we're at pub number 8 on this particular pub crawl, and it's the Rising Sun. Plenty of nice real beers in here. This place is supposedly from 1747. So technically this is one of the oldest pubs, certainly on this crawl. Anything to add on this one, Barbara? The Rising Sun?
This is one of three Manchester pubs, Rising Sun, the Nag's Head and the Abercrombie, which have two entrances, so you can go from one street and then come out of the pub at the next street. Apparently, the reason given is either you can escape from the police arriving, or you can escape from your wife, or your husband these days, but never mind. But anyway, check out the features of these three pubs. Yeah, walk from one entrance to the next street through the pub. So, yeah, this is a nice pub.
It is.
The other side of it fronts onto Lincoln Square.
Yeah,
with
it does.
A statue of Abraham Lincoln.
There is. We might walk past there on the way to pub number 9.
Okay.
All right. See you in a minute.
Later.
Bye. Okay, we're at pub number 9 on the pub crawl, and we're at the Ape and Apple on John Dalton Street. John Dalton was a famous Manchester chemist, just the name of the street. The actual pub isn't very old, we think it's the 90s, but it's been decked out inside to look old. So it's still quite nice, has lots of sports bars. Anything to add on it, Barbara?
It has a mixed clientele with local office workers, shoppers and people going bobbing by to watch the football on many big screens. It's a Joseph Holt's local beer, so it's cheap and with good food on as well.
Yep.
Upstairs they have a comedy night every Wednesday night. Check it out, it's a nice pub.
Yeah, it's a nice pub, and it's not too far from the next pub, so let's move on to pub number 10.
Hi.
Now we're on pub number 10 of the classic pubs pub crawl, and we're at the City Arms, which is a fantastic little pub, well known within Manchester. Loads of great ales, really nice inside, plenty of tiles, etc. Like a central bar area, it's just fantastic. Anything to add on this one, Barbara?
No, if this one's too busy for you, make sure that you go to the Vine Inn next door. Also, another historic Manchester bar with a beautiful green tiling and lovely wood inside. So, either one of these books will do.
Yeah, but, 18th century buildings, aren't they?
Yeah, tiled houses. Yeah. So, both lovely in their own right. We couldn't really choose, but just choose one.
Yeah. Both. Okay, we'll move on to the final pub, which is pub number 11. We moved a massive distance from the City Arms there to the Waterhouse next door. Now this is a really big, not particularly old pub, but the actual building is very old. It's called the Waterhouse, named after Alfred Waterhouse, who designed the Town Hall. The Town Hall is a fantastic building, being renovated at the moment, it's superb. Waterhouse also designed Strangeways Prison, Victorian Prison in Manchester, and also the Science Museum in London. Oh, sorry, the Natural History Museum in London. It's a great pub. It's Wetherspoons, so don't let that put you off. It's big, it's got loads of beers, loads of food, and as always in the Wetherspoons, the toilets are amazing. And after 11 pints, you might well need them. Anything to add on that, Barbara?
Yeah, this is the building goes quite a long way back. It's a big pub. It's actually three houses joined together. So if you can spot the join and spot the original features, like the windows behind us. So this is the end of today's crawl.
Yeah.
From here you can wander down to St Peter's Square, catch a tram to any station, to Victoria, Piccadilly Station, or walk, sort of 10 minutes, quarter of an hour, but to various stations. But you are right in the middle of the city centre, so convenient for most places.
Yeah, this is one of my favourite crawls because you do hear a lot of the really old traditional pubs.
Yeah,
it's fantastic,
definitely.
Really love it.
Yeah.
Anyway, we're going to see you on another crawl another day. So,
okay.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.